roughly 50 to 60% of the world's corals have been lost. One of the major functions of coral reefs is to be an offshore break of waves coming in. So they really protect the coastlines. It's urgent, very urgent. The time is now, and I really think we can make a meaningful difference.
The Coral Restoration Foundation is trying to take a very active approach to reef restoration.
We know that we can grow coral in a nursery, and we know that we can plant that coral on the reef. And now the only question is, how much coral can we get out there, and how quickly can we do it?
Corals are probably the most complicated but seemingly simple critters around. Corals are animals, minerals, and plants all at the same time. Coral reefs come from multiple corals existing in the same space, and all of those different nooks and crannies become homes for other animals. When corals experience water temperatures that are too high for too long, they in essence bleach and they essentially starve. If corals go away, there's a lot of damage on land that's going to happen. So we're doing a fair amount of research on coral resilience, looking at coral genetics, looking at the physiology of corals, all the way up to actual genetic manipulation of a coral to be more resilient to heat events.
Research is a critical aspect of what we do at the Coral Restoration Foundation. But eventually you have to move from the research side to the practice side.
A day on the water for us might start with a quick run out to one of our nurseries.
We have a suite of offshore coral nurseries. They're located about 3 miles off the Florida Keys. We propagate them and we maintain them on what's known as a coral tree, which is a method that we actually pioneered at the Coral Restoration Foundation.
We collect some of the corals, and then we'll bring those corals up out of the nursery, place them on the boat, drive the boat out to a reef site, and then get in the water with those corals and start planting them.
The first year that CRF outplanted corals, we outplanted 6. Last year in 2018, we planted 25,000. This year we're going for about 30,000. So we are trying to replace and start to rebuild a lot of the populations that were lost.
The coral tree is now internationally regarded as one of the best ways for growing large numbers of coral.
What we've seen is actually accelerates their growth rate 3 to 6 times faster, depending on the species, than a coral that is on the reef itself.
That is seriously scaling up your restoration capacity. As we scaled up, we went from 1,000 corals to 5,000 corals to 10,000 corals every year. We realized this is incredibly time consuming. And so what we've done at CRF is implemented a photomosaic monitoring program where we create huge, super high resolution images of the reef area where we've been working and then use those images to monitor restoration success. And it also gives us much more relevant insights as we continue to scale up to that reef-wide level.
We have a long way to go. It's definitely not an easy path, but if I didn't think that we were onto something, I wouldn't be able to continue to do the work that we do.
These kinds of pie in the sky ideals are actually more practical than you think. You just need to commit to doing it on a scale that makes a lasting long-term impact.
Hey, thanks for watching. In this series by Freethink, we're looking at some of the boldest ideas for dealing with the changing climate. We've got more videos coming up soon. Hit subscribe now and you'll get to see those as soon as they're released.